All right, so 7-5 has a little bit of a twist. So you're undoing multiplication and division inequalities, but you need to be very, very careful when you're undoing with a negative. So let's see. This one's just a basic one. It's multiplication, undo with division. And I have x is everything less than or equal to 6. Go ahead and graph it. I always want you to graph it, even when they don't say you don't need to graph it. I think you need to graph it just so you get a good visual of what it means with an inequality. It includes 6 and it's everything to the left, okay? And then pick a value less than 6, 0, right? Mm-hmm. 9 times 0, is it less than or equal to 54? It sure is. So 0 is less than or equal to 54. So it checks. When they're positive, it's easy. Division, undo division with multiplication. So you're going to multiply both sides by 9. Make sure you put 9 above it, not underneath. So you can show cancel. D is every value greater than 36. And then, of course, graph it. I have 36. It excludes 36 because there's no equal sign, and it's everything to the right. Now, pick a number greater than 36 that gets along with 9. Don't pick a number that ends up with a decimal or a fraction. Pick a number that gets along, is divisible by 9. Well, 45 would work. So let's do 45 divided by 9. Is that greater than 4? Yeah, 5 is greater than 4. So it checks. Okay, so remember with division, when you go to check it, pick a number that works with the denominator. Goes into it evenly. Okay, so this one, yep. Divide both sides by 3. Why is everything greater than 7? This one, multiply both sides by 3. Make sure you put it on the side and not underneath. Then P, these cancel. P is every value greater than or equal to 18. First, we want to see what our equation looks like. Martha earns $9 per hour working for a fast food restaurant. Which inequality can be used to find how many hours she must work in a week to earn at least, at the very least, $243? So you have to ask yourself, is she okay with earning $243? I think so, because she said at the very least. Does she want to earn more than $243? I think so. So which one is showing that she wants to earn more than or equal to 243? And your answer would be B. Ed earns $6 per hour working at the library. Which inequality can be used to find out how many hours he must work a week to earn more than $100? So this one will be D. He wants more than. He doesn't want $100. He wants more than. All right, this is where you have to be careful. So whenever you are multiplying or dividing to undo an inequality with a negative, your sign has to flip. It just works like that, as I described it in class to you. So these cancel. You need to do a flip and get x is everything less than or equal to negative 35. Otherwise, it won't work. If you go to try and check it without flipping it, it won't work. So that's how you know that you did it wrong. So here's negative 35. It's everything, including negative 35 and less. Pick a number that gets along with 5. So let's pick what? 40? Good idea. So negative 40 divided by negative 5, greater than or equal to 7. Negative 40 divided by negative 5 is 8, and 8 is greater than 7, so it checks. So you have to, very important, okay, flip the sign when you are multiplying or dividing by a negative value, okay? Not when you're adding, only when you're multiplying or dividing. So you look at this one, are you gonna flip it? Yeah, you're gonna flip it. because when you go and solve this inequality, you're going to divide by a negative 9. That means flip. So you're just going to go in the opposite direction, and you're going to get x is everything greater than 3. Big value greater than 3, 4, 5, whatever you want, 10, good idea. Negative 9 times 10, is that less than negative 27? Now remember, you only flip it for the solution. Then you go back to the original problem to check it in the unflipped version. So the only place it's flipped is right here in the solution. So you can pick a value greater than 3. Once you do, then you put it back to the unflipped version, the original. You always check back in the original. We flip, yep, because you're gonna multiply by negative 3, so flip away. So it's end up going this way, and x is everything less than negative 18. You're gonna flip, yep. So this one's gonna be greater than or equal to, and it's gonna be x is everything greater than or equal to. And there's your graphs. Excluded to the left, included to the right. And that's it for 7.5.